Well, good morning, everyone, on this 24th day of December, the day before the celebration of the birth of Jesus, and welcome. This morning, we will have our scripture readings by Freddie Lewis, and Betty Bauerreis will read the Venite, and at the end, the general thanksgiving. So I'll begin with a few opening sentences, and then we will go to page 79 for the confession. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. The glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. A virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel. And now the confession on page 79. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, by what we have done. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves.
We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent.
Bill, can you hear us? You may have frozen. Did he go out? Let's just continue with the Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life.
Amen.
Continuing with the invitatory on page 80. Lord, open our lips.
And our mouths shall clean your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son,
and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning,
is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's not back yet, is he? Our King and Savior now draws near. Come, let us adore him. And who was some?
I'm question? Going to do it.
You were going to read the Venite. Okay.
Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is he, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
Our appointed psalm is our 45 and 46, found on page 647. There he is.
There he is.
I'm sorry, we had a power blip here. I don't know what.
Bill, we're about to start the psalm on page 647. So you take it from here.
Okay, thank you. And I do apologize.
No.
Not your problem.
Psalm 45 on page 647. My heart is stirring with a noble song. Let me recite what I have fashioned for the King.
My tongue shall be the children of the Savior.
You are the fairest of men.
Grace
flows from your lips. God is blessed forever.
Strap your sword upon your thigh, O mighty warrior.
In your pride and in your majesty.
Ride out and conquer in the cause of truth.
And for the sake of
justice.
Your right hand will show you marvelous things. The peoples are falling at your feet.
And the king is losing his heart.
Your throne, O God, endures forever and ever.
A scepter of righteousness
is the scepter of your kingdom.
You love righteousness,
you love righteousness and hate iniquity.
Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you
with oil of gladness above
your fellows.
All your garments are fragrant with myrrh, aloes, and cassia.
And the music
of the ivory
King's daughters stand among the ladies of the court.
On your right hand is the queen,
adorned with gold and ophir.
Hear, O daughter, consider and listen closely.
Forget your father's counsel.
The king will have pleasure in your beauty.
He is your master, therefore do him honor.
The people of Tyre are here with a gift.
The rich among the people seek your favor.
All glorious is the princess as she enters.
Her gown is cloth of gold.
In embroidered apparel, she is brought to the king.
After her, the bridesmaids follow in the procession.
With joy and gladness, they are brought.
And enter into the palace of the king.
In place of fathers, O king, you shall have sons.
You shall make the princes call the earth.
I will make your name to be remembered from one generation to another.
Therefore, nations will praise you forever and ever.
And now Psalm 46 on page 649. God is our refuge and strength.
A very present help in trouble.
Therefore, we will not fear though the earth be moved.
Though the mountains be toppled into the depths of the sea, though its waters rage and foam.
And though the mountains tremble,
the Lord of hosts is with us.
The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God.
The holy heaven is the most high.
God is in the midst of her. She shall not be overthrown.
God shall help her at the break of day.
The nations make much ado, and the kingdoms are shaken.
God has spoken.
The Lord of hosts is with us.
The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
Come now and look upon the works of the Lord. It is he who makes war to cease in all the world.
He breaks the spear and burns the shield and fire.
Be still then and know that I am God.
I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us.
The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
Glory to God, glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
And now the readings from the scriptures.
A reading from Isaiah. Excuse me. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly. And rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make him the feeble knees. Say to those who are of fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance and terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. From the lame shall leap like deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For water shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The haunt of jackals shall become a swamp. The grass shall become reeds and rushes. A highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Holy Way. The unclean shall not travel on it, but it shall be for God's people. No traveler, not even fools, shall go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravenous beast come up on it. They shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there. And the ransomed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall attain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Awake and greet the new morn. Awake, awake and greet the new morn, for angels herald its dawning. Sing out your joy, for soon he is born. Behold the child of our longing. Come as a baby weak and poor, to bring all hearts together. He opens wide the heavenly door, and lives now inside us forever. At midnight deep his coming shall be, when all the world is despairing. As morning light, so quiet and free, so warm and gentle and caring. Then shall the mute break forth in song, the lame shall leap in wonder. The weak be raised above the strong, and weapons be broken asunder. Rejoice, rejoice, take heart in the night, though long the winter is cheerless. The rising sun shall crown you with might. Be strong and loving and fearless. Love be our song and love our prayer, and love our endless story. May God fill every day we share, and bring us at last into glory.
The second reading from Luke. John's father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke this prophecy. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has looked favorably on his people and redeemed them. He has raised up a mighty Savior for us in the house of his servant David, as he spoke through the mouth of his holy prophets from of old, that we would be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us. Thus he has shown the mercy promised to our ancestors and has remembered his holy covenant, the oath that he swore to our ancestor Abraham, to grant us that we, being rescued from the hands of our enemies, might serve him without fear in holiness and righteousness before him all our days. And you, child, will be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his ways, to give knowledge of salvation to his people, by the forgiveness of their sins, by the tender mercy of our God. The dawn from on high will break upon us, to give light to those who sit in the darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. The child grew and became strong in spirit. He was in the wilderness until the day he appeared publicly to Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Apostles' Creed is found on page 96. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he arose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now the prayers on page 97. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now we will read Suffrages B on page 98. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and hold them now and always.
Day by day, we bless you.
We pray for your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
Purify our conscience, Almighty God, by your daily visitation, that your Son Jesus Christ, at his coming, may find in us a mansion prepared for himself, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
As we call to mind a world that dearly needs your presence, we pray, saying, Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. O God, you are our Savior. For the Church, gathering together in many and various ways around the world this Advent, hear our heartfelt voices cry aloud as we pray. Amen. Amen.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Make your deeds known among the peoples, for our nation and all nations. May your peace and justice be manifest in every corner of the earth, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Come, Lord Jesus. We rejoice in you and call upon your name. May children grow in loving whatever is just and true and good. We pray. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. You are our stronghold and our sure defense. For the sick, the suffering, and those in distress of any kind. For caregivers, chaplains, and all healthcare and essential workers, for scientists and volunteers working on vaccines and searching for cures, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Come, Lord Jesus.
We thank you for being in our midst. In you we trust and will not be afraid. May your presence be with those whom we love but see no longer. We pray. Amen.
Amen.
Come, Lord Jesus.
O Lord, our God, make us watchful and keep us faithful as we await the coming of your Son, that at his appearing, he may not find us asleep, but active in his service and joyful in his praise. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Come, Lord Jesus.
We offer prayers now for those known to us and our community. After their names are read, you may share your own prayers aloud or in the chat column.
We pray for Dave, Ken, Emily, Jerry, Dee Dee, Jean, Michael, Josephine, and Edward.
We pray for Sally, Joel, Kathy, Anne, Suzanne, and Barbara. For Liz, Ed, Posey, and Grace. For Francis, Kay, Charlotte, and Kit. From Michael, Oline, and Dana. For Bruce, Cindy. For Wright and Eileen, Carl, John, and Glow. For Heather, Jane, Carol, Susan, and Bruce. For Francis Hagen, Melissa, Lucy, and Henry, and Jim. For Kel, Kathy, and Kel. For Dick and Daniel. We pray also for Mike and David. Are there others?
My grandson, Ethan, who's been exposed to COVID-19.
Betty.
I invite your thanksgivings.
I'm thankful to see Raymond Burke.
I am too. And new reader, Brady Lewis. Thank you. A different voice.
I'm thankful for meeting with you all. For the gift of Dr. Fauci on the feast of his nativity.
Absolutely.
And for Bill, I'm glad Bill got back.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And for the safe arrival of
I'm thankful for Pierce's leadership for this past year. It's just been a wonder to know him and a real pleasure. Thank you.
Amen.
He's going to officiate one last time on Monday. Or maybe he'll join us. Who knows? Hopefully he will.
Yeah.
Cheryl, I feel like it can't be said enough how much we appreciate you. And just keeping this group together like you have and in your beautiful way and just your gentle way. And we thank you so much. It's been really special.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It's my pleasure.
So we conclude these prayers as Betty Bauer Rice will read the general thanksgiving.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory, we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Amen.
Let heaven rejoice and earth be glad. Let heaven rejoice and earth be glad. Let all creation sing. Let children proclaim in every land, Hosanna to our King. Sound the trumpet into the night. The day of the Lord is near. Wake his people, lift your voice, proclaim it to the world. Let heaven rejoice and earth be glad. Let all creation sing. Let children proclaim through every land, Hosanna to our King. Rise in splendor, shake off your sleep, put on your robes of joy, and in the morning shall see the glory of the Lord. Let heaven rejoice and earth be glad. Let all creation sing. Let children proclaim through every land, Hosanna to our King. Let children proclaim in every land, Hosanna to our King.
Holy and sovereign Lord, when the earth and all its people quake, you hold its pillars firm. What is uncertain and frightening to us is completely known to you and controlled by you. Look mercifully on the people of St. James and other parishes represented here. Although at this time we are apart from each other, we pray your Holy Spirit will unite us as one. Pour upon us your peace, which passes all understanding. Keep us safe and healthy. And above all, keep us mindful of those to whom we should show the love and compassion of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you, Bill. Glad you made it back.
Thank you.
Grab your families tomorrow morning for a special Christmas Day morning prayer. We're going to start about 4 minutes, 3 or 4 minutes early with the prelude. Lots of music, everything from Westminster Abbey to Motown. So,
Cheryl,
yes.
A public service announcement. Speaking of music, don't forget that Lessons and Carols from King's College, Cambridge will be on 92.7 at 10 o'clock this morning. So if you have a chance, tune in.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, thank you for the reminder. I really had let it go. Woof. So thanks. By all means, I hope to see some of you at the service this afternoon. Maybe we can at least get through the 2 o'clock. But we'll pray what will be, and I hope to see you tomorrow or at downtown at church at 10:30 maybe. So, okay, have a great day.
Celebrate the day.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.